going 3% every quarter to AIG, but that didn't happen. And so many people did that, and all these companies reported projects didn't work. And what happened? The actual value of this company or the debt was in 1 million, and outstanding insurances on this 1 million was 1 trillion. Who will pay that? So AIG went running to the government and said that I'm an insurer and please bail me out. I don't have money to pay anybody. The government out. And then India learned the lesson, or say overlearned the lesson. The actual purpose of CDS is providing liquidity in the bond market or say debt market. So many people, I mean AAA rated companies very easily get loans from everywhere. But what about the companies with innovative ideas, good ideas, excellent projects and investment opportunities who are not getting through the lenders? Nobody will lend. In this way, infrastructure companies will not be in a position of doing anything. So a serious market was created to help these kind of companies. So Indian government also implemented CDS in December 2011 in India, via charter. But there were a lot of restrictions on who will be selling CDS, who will be buying CDS, and on the settlement of the CDS. These restrictions were, speculation is not allowed. Mr. H was a speculator, these speculators have no place in it. Only those people who have given loans can buy CDS protection, and in case of a default, physical delivery of the bond is to be given. Suppose that there is a default and there is a company, say SBI is selling CDS, then when SBI will pay the money to the company to whom it has sold CDS, that company will hand over the bonds to this is physical delivery. If you are a speculator, you don't have bonds, you are not part of the game. One thing is. And the other thing is, all the institutions who can sell the CDS, the NBFCs, non-banking corporations, and some other institutions, they have to keep a bare minimum balance. They have to keep some capital to show that in case some of the insurances that they have sold default, there are default events, they are in a position of paying the money. So these are the kind of conditions. So in Indian context, CDS cannot work. It will not deepen the Indian bond markets. Indian bond markets are in a very recent stage. Not many people are investing into bonds. Most people are investing into equities. So that is the condition in India. And now I think you people have some idea about CDS and what are mortgages, what impact securities, how they are sold, and how the crisis happened. Questions?
आप फिजिकल इंडिया
D grade is the default grade. Although the returns are very high. shares what you get?
Anything pertaining to finance?
anything pertaining to finance you want to ask? Pertaining to this topic, what do you expect to study in finance course? Now I know why the teachers ask about the breakfast when they come to class. Government policies aren't good. You can't get food here.
Ma'am, can you tell something about the current situation regarding value of rupee?
The valuation of rupee, why this is happening, there will be a number of reasons about it. The slowdown of economic activities, the exports of the company, the exports of the country are not enough, and the imports are exceedingly increasing. The service sector is improving. There are a number of reasons of that. But why rupee is depreciating? Other than the reasons which I should not mention in the class, that is corruption and inefficient policy making. So rupee is depreciating, but I think now it has recovered, and the petroleum prices were rising. India had to the Indian gold reserves were also decreasing. India had to import a lot of goods from abroad, and if a country is importing a lot of goods from abroad, what it has to do? It has to pay a lot of, it has to convert Indian rupees into some other currency to buy those goods from there. So what happens? There is a demand and supply condition where there are a lot of Indian rupees in the market, and by those rupees, other currencies are being bought. What is happening? Due to the abundance of this import by India, Indian currency is being infused in the market, and because the supply is so much and people are not exporting from India, so they are not paying their currency to India and not converting them anywhere. You are getting my point? What exactly is happening? India is importing goods, including petroleum and other goods. So India is paying a lot of Indian rupees in the market. But nobody is buying from India. So there is no balance. This is devaluating the, depreciating the value of rupee. Lot of rupee, nobody to purchase it, it has no value. So against all the major currencies, dollar and pound, yen and euro, the currency is becoming weaker and weaker and weaker. That actually happens. You have got the answer? That is the easiest way to tell you. That the supply of Indian rupee has increased in the overseas market, and nobody is importing goods from India, so Indian currency is in superabundance.
Outflow is more important. And in short, the import is high and export is
low. That is why, you know what happened. There was a time when Indian rupee was very strong against Indian dollar. Say 32 rupees it had become. So it was very strong against the US dollar. So what? There comes RBI and starts, you know, doing interventions. When Indian rupee is very, very strong, what RBI would do? RBI would infuse Indian money in the market so that money will start weakening against other currencies. And when there is a lot of Indian rupee in the market, then this value will. The Indian rupee will depreciate, and exporters of India will benefit. Can somebody tell me how